Well, a very good morning, children. Today in this class, we are going to discuss about a new topic. Before that, I want to inform that yesterday I have sent the question answers. Just you have to write down all those question answers in the fair book neatly. And next, whatever the question answers I have given to Bahat, you have to Bahat that also and write it in the last page of the fair book. Okay, last page of the fair book, you have to copy those question answers. One time question, two time answers. Right? Okay, see. So today in this class we are going to discuss about a new topic, so which is very interesting and which will teach us value of the animals, value of organisms, value of life. Okay, so that is what the lesson, threatened species. Okay, threatened species we are going to discuss. Right, threatened species means they are already in danger. Okay, the species which are in danger position, which are at risk, their lives are at risk. So, as we know that it is true that all of the living organism who has taken the birth on the earth, that is not going to stay on earth forever. Right? So, we are not going to stay on the earth for 1000 years for a life, even for the until the earth has living. Okay, it means that one day we are going to die. One day every living organism it's going to die. Right, but if the animals are destroying dozens swiftly, it will be destroying continuously, countlessly, for the entertainment purpose, it's not good. Right, so it is the it is what the thing which we are discussing today. So all the lives are very important on the earth. So we are not going to stay on the earth forever. Plants and animals, both of us, both the living organisms, one day they are going to destroy, one day they are going to die. But there are some species, there are some organisms which are going to die, which are already killed. We can say that they are killing, they are destroying, they are murdered by the human beings for their entertainment purpose, for their happiness, hunting. So by the hunting they are killing so many animals. This is resulting in the destroying of the total destroying of those species permanently on the earth. They are going to the species are in the endangered position. Okay, they are going to destroy completely. See, as I told, plants and animals, both of us are related to each other. We are interconnected to each other. Even plants are not there means animals can't survive. If the animals are not there means plants can't survive. Both of us are continuously, interconnected with each other. So this means what? That every species, every organisms are very important on the earth to maintain the ecological balance. Okay, so today in this class we are going to discuss about that topic only, which is very interesting and which will give a good, good lesson for us, good message for us. So that is threatened species. Okay, so as we know that there are so many species of the organisms which are going to destroy and which are not even visible to our eyes now, right now. Okay, they are not seeing on the earth. So dinosaurs, but the best examples in the previous, so many years ago there will be the dinosaurs, but right now we are not able to see the dinosaurs. Only in the pictures we are able to see the dinosaurs. Right, in the live examples we are not able to see the examples, dinosaurs clearly. But the thing is that if you are continuously making like this only, if you are continuously killing the animals like this only, means one day we are also not staying on the earth. See, just think that if anybody killed us without any reason for their joy purpose, means what will happen? How will you feel? Is it good? No, it's not good. Like that only, every organism have a rights to lead their life, live their life. Okay, so we are not supposed to kill their, take their life because of our happiness. Right now, so for that reason, government has made so many rules and regulations. They strictly prohibited the killing of the animals, wild animals, especially wild animals. And still, there are some people for their joyness, for their happiness, the hunting is going on and they will kill. And for the, even for the illegal processes. Okay, as we know that the wild animal skin is exporting, it's good, it costs a lot. Even elephant's tusks, that is also that will also used for the making of the powder and perfumes like that. So this is what this all what we commercially they are commercially profits are there, you know, for that reason also there are some people they are used to kill the animals for their profit. So this is what the main reason, but still government has strictly prohibited the killing of so many animals. Even though they have strictly done these all rules and regulations, there are some species of animals they are already get extinct. Means they are already not on the earth only. Only the pictures in the, we can see that these animals like dinosaur will be like this. Like this, okay. So this is what happening in the earth. For that reason only, World Conservation Union, this is ICUN. Okay, this is prepared the Red Data Book. Red Data Book. They have done a Red Data Book, which is which will mention in this Red Data Book, the government will mention that how many species are available on the earth. And how many species are endangered, extinct, endangered, and vulnerable? Like this, they will make the category, and according to that, they will take care of all those animals more. So we think about that. So extinct means what? Means they will in this red data book only they will make the parts like extinct. Okay. Completely destroyed on the earth. We are not able to see that all species on the earth only. Live species on the earth. Extinct refers to species which are no longer known to exist in the wild. They are gone forever. They are already gone forever. Those species of those type of species are referred to as extinct. They are completely vanished. We are not able to see that species on the earth. Okay, next one is that is critically endangered. Critically endangered means what? They are the animals, the species are high risk. They are at high risk. They are, we have to take care of them a lot. Already 90 to 95% of the species were gone. Means critical endangered, I am telling you, give me an example. 90 to 95% of that examples are already dead. They are not even able to see that, but they are very in the critical stage. So we have to protect their habitats. As we know that habitat is what? Habitat means the place where the climatic conditions which will support our organisms to stay there, live there and lead their life. Okay, so how we have a house and we have a place to live, so that like that only every organism needs a habitat. Okay, if the habitat is not there, means survival also not possible for any organism. Okay, so like that we are their population is very low and threats to their habitats very high. Okay, their threats means their habitats are going to decreasing. So even the species are going to less. They are continuously decreasing in their number also. So like that, it is affecting on their habitats also. Yeah, as well as the species is also in the critical risk. So we have to take care of those type of animals a lot. Okay, next one is that endangered. Okay, endangered means what? Endangered means these species also at risk only. These species habitat also at risk only. But the thing is that if we are aware now, if we are starting to take care of those type of endangered species, there may be a chances we can save those type of species on the earth. Clear? So we have to take a lot who are in the endangered position. If they are in the endangered position, it's our duty to take care of those species a lot, and we have to provide a habitat for those organisms. Okay, so we have to start them taking care, and we have to provide the good food, and we have to provide the habitat for those type of species. Then only we are able to save those type of species on the earth. And last one, that is vulnerable. Vulnerable is what? Protection. Okay, we have to protect and we have to provide a habitat for them also. The vulnerable refers to species that are not at endangered but are at risk of losing their specific habitats. Okay, so as we know that habitats are very necessary. So for each organism, habitat is very necessary. So vulnerable species means what? They are not even at risk, but they need a good habitat. They need the habitat to live their life. Okay, if you are not providing the habitat for them, if you are destroying the those habitats, so there will be the it will be quite common. It will be directly result in the, they will also postpone in the endangered, critically endangered, and next one it will once it will extinct. Okay, so main intention of this lesson, as I told, that only to know about the how the organisms are extincted. Okay, how they are killing, what our duty to protect them. Okay, for our happiness, for our joyness, it's not good to kill any organism. This is only the message that the lesson is giving to us. And extinct species, one more is that cheetah. That is Asiatic cheetah. Okay, once again I will repeat this, guys. Just have a look on this. Extinct means already they are vanished. Means already they are destroyed species. A critically endangered means the species is who are at high risky level. Okay, they are almost killed only. If you are taking care means now a lot means then only there may be the chances of having those species with us on the earth. And next one is endangered. These are not that much risk like the critical endangered, but still they are at risk only. We have to provide a good habitat for them, because endangered means their habitat is going to reduce and further reduce. If it is continuously going on to reduce, means there may be the it will be resulting in the, it will also want to the critically endangered and next to extinct. And vulnerable means this is the category here. The species are not in a endangered or critically endangered position or state, but still we have to provide a good habitat for them, and we have to take a good care of those species also. This is about what these all four categories only in the red data book they will mention. So in their categorize the species like that only, and they will do survey. Okay, yearly they will do survey on the wildlife, even the forests also. By that they will come to know which species are available on the earth and how many species are available on the earth. They will come to know easily. Okay, understood now? Okay. Okay, this much for this class, guys. If you have any doubts, please let me know that. And I hope you enjoy the class. Just read the lesson. Be safe, stay safe, and connect with the textbooks. And don't use mobile that much. Okay, and maintain a good handwriting in the fair book. Don't force me to give the rewrite again. Just allow, however you are staying in the home only, just make sure that your handwriting should be good, neat, clear. Okay. Have a good day. Thank you.